Drew and T are partway through their Northern Irish journey. Today, they're leaving the city and driving 30 miles south to County Armagh and the town of Portadown. It's here that they'll be visiting a business linked to the pub industry.
One thing Ireland is not short of is bars.
I hadn't noticed, actually.
Yeah, yeah. We could just visit one, maybe, before we leave. I'm not going to be reading scripture tonight. I'm just going to make sure...
No,
I was just going to sit and read poetry, but I thought we could probably go to a pub, can't we?
Well, I do worry that they affect the inner ear, because last time I was looking at a pub and some people fell over after they came out. So it must affect your balance terribly.
They're off to meet Gerard Derry, owner of Derry's Limited. Established in the 1980s, they supply furnishings for pubs in Ireland and around the world. There's a workshop making new and reproduction furniture, as well as warehouses of pub memorabilia and architectural antiques.
My father was an antique dealer, so he was himself. And then we moved on, as I came into the business then, I started to develop into doing bar furniture. There were some very quirky pieces here, so unusual things you just wouldn't find everywhere. And so I think there'd be plenty for him to pick from here.
Hi there.
How do you do?
Jared?
Yeah,
Drew. Nice to meet you.
How are you?
How you doing?
I am T.
T, how do you
You're
do?
Well.
Glad to meet you.
I couldn't miss the place.
No.
It stands out from the countryside.
It's noticeable as it is.
Can we have a look inside?
Oh, you can, certainly. Come on ahead.
Oh, my God. Are you kidding?
That wooden Jaguar?
Yeah, knee tape.
Yeah. It wouldn't go?
Yeah, the car with the wooden wheels and the wooden engine.
You could carve someone up on the motorway.
They have a full-size wooden Jaguar E-Type. I've never seen the like of it in my life. It's absolutely mad. Oh, you're selling it as well?
Oh, yeah.
How much?
£6,500 with a full MOT.
Are you tempted?
No. That's one car I'm not going to be buying today.
Drew's not in the market for a wooden car, but that's not the only thing with wheels that's caught his eye.
Kawasaki 90, very unusual bike.
I've never seen one,
no. No, they're very unusual bikes for us.
I like that. How much is that?
£1,500.
Does it run?
I never had it running. I think it would go.
That'll
yeah,
go.
Just
That'll go.
Plug's done.
That'll go. Blimey. Not what I expected. I came here looking for furniture. I've come to Ireland and I've fallen in love with a Black Beauty, and it's not Guinness. It is just this fantastic little 90cc bike.
This Japanese Kawasaki M10 motorbike is in fact a rare model produced in 1966. With its 90cc engine, it was one of Kawasaki's first small capacity street bikes. In mint condition, it could be worth around £2,000.
Would a grand buy it?
I split it with you, so I'll do the split the difference.
£1,250.
Yeah, I'll have it. There we
Thank
go.
You. It's a long time since I've bought something that make me feel that happy immediately, and I had to have it. I can hear it running. I can feel how it's going to be when I'm riding it. Over the moon.
To make back the cost of the bike, not to mention the trip, Drew needs to get down to business.
OK, so this is more the antique.
Yeah,
the
original
mix, a mixture. I have to actually do some proper work now, T.
What?
Actually buy something I'm going to...
I can sell. Not for you.
You've got the bits for these?
No, I don't have the fittings for them.
You don't have the fittings?
No.
These opaque glass shades are from the 1950s and most likely came out of a pub. Once they're fitted with suspension chains, ceiling hooks and rewired, they could sell for around £250 each.
What sort of money are they? As they are, just the glass.
20 on the run.
£20?
Yep.
For that one?
Yep.
That one?
Yep.
That one?
That's it.
Oh.
The one at the ends.
What about this one?
Yeah, that's the same money. £20.
£20?
Same.
£20 for any shades on here. There's another one of those there.
Yep.
Yep. Have a deal. Marvellous, thank you.
Something I buy an awful lot of is lighting. I'll buy galleries, chain, ceiling fittings, you name it, I'll buy it, whatever it is. Because after a time, you end up with a huge collection of stuff like we have, so you're able to make up other lights. Incomplete really knocks the price.
That wax head up there?
£120.
OK. Can we get it down and have a look at it?
Yeah, so, certainly.
They don't survive so well, those, do they?
That's in very good shape, but.
OK, get that one. Do you know how to get on in this world?
Get ahead. I don't want that one. What sort of age would you have on him?
1930, would you?
Got a very strange look, hasn't he?
It might look a bit creepy, but he just has a very odd, far away, distant expression. And even the cracks are attractive, and it's on an old piece of wood, and it's more or less complete. I like things like that, so, you know, you buy what you like, don't you?
There's a passing resemblance there, T.
This wax mannequin is thought to be French and probably dates back to the 1920s. Used for shop window dressing, this one has glass eyes and real human hair. It could be worth around £300.
120, 100 quid?
OK.
Yeah?
Deal done.
He will probably end up with another dealer, probably in the States. They are very, very keen on this type of thing out there, so that's probably where that's going to go.
With his shopping spree over, it's now time to load up.
The only thing I'm slightly concerned about is in Wales, and it's the missus, and I'm not sure how she's going to take another wheeled thing arriving at the house.
That's been very interesting. So it has. Drew has bought a few pieces from us here. He got a motorbike worth the money as well.
The profitable piece of the day was buying all of those light shades. We'll make some really good money on those.
I think he was happy with it, what he got, and I'm happy with what I've got, so we're all, hopefully we can do business again sometime.
Done.
Sorted.
Happy.
All loaded. Yeah.
Jared, thank you
very
much.
For the road. Thank
pleasure.
You. Thank you for the business.
Thank you so much.
Thanks. Call again.
Definitely, for sure.
All right. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay. Cheers. Bye-bye.
See you later. Right, see you
now. After a week away, it's time to show the new stock to the team.
Bigorra, bigorra, top bigorra. Of the morning to you, to be sure.
Was it worth it?
Check it out. Full van.
Drew's opened the shutter at the back of the lorry and it's jammed to the hilt. It's fantastic.
We went to Derry's. Jared Derry, lovely fella. Check that out.
Oh, wow.
So if you can get a very, very strong gallery and something that's got a sort of brutalist, industrially look to it, that would be great. You got anything? We must have.
Must have something.
Must have. Check these out. All the lights are 20 quid each. All lights, 20 quid each.
Every light Drew got out of the box, he went, £20, £20, £20. That's a good price, £20.
OK, that front door looks familiar.
We'll talk about that later.
No, we won't. I saw on the back of the van, under a blanket, a motorcycle wheel. Here we go again, another bike.
Like, that's a motorbike.
Behold. I just fell in love with it. It's just lovely. Look at that. 1966. So it's a really early 90cc M10 Kawasaki.
Do you know what?
What?
I'd quite like that.
It's fantastic, isn't it?
It's little.
Is it running?
Hear it. Yeah. You know that's going to go, isn't
I'll
it?
I'll get that going. Yeah.
Every now and again, something just gets you, and I just had to have it.
Lo and behold, I absolutely adore it. It's so cool. I mean, it's so trendy. And it's small. It's, you know, it's manageable. It's not sort of scary.
I love it.
Hallelujah. But, happy days.
Not for me.
Yes, darling.
Please.
When's your birthday? Yeah, no problem. Yeah. Go on then, let's get it in. Isn't that fantastic?
Yes. Now, I'm not cross.